My name is Abed Dandashi. I'm a clinical nurse educator. I'm graduated in Lebanon on 2003. Our presentation today is about adult asthma care guideline for nurses. First, what's asthma? Asthma is a chronic inflammatory disorder of the airways characterized by an increase in airway responsiveness and airway narrowing. Asthma is usually classified as mild, moderate, and severe. Asthma episode may begin suddenly or may have a slow onset with a gradual worsening of symptoms. This episode can last for a few minutes or several days. What causes asthma? Usually, there is no exact cause for asthma. The exact cause of asthma is not known. There are several triggers that may irritate the hypertensive airways in people with asthma and provoke an asthma episode. The common trigger include irritants such as tobacco smoke, exercise, exposure to chemical and outdoor pollutants, allergens such as pet dander, dust, foods, and cockroach allergen, allergic rhinitis, sinusitis, or gastroesophageal reflux may aggravate also the asthma. Sign and symptoms. The sign and symptoms are common, and it's including wheezing, coughing, difficulty of breathing, tightness in the chest, worsening symptoms at night, and worsening symptoms due to cold air. Prevalence and impact of asthma. Almost 300 million people in the world have been diagnosed with asthma. 6 in 10 individuals with asthma are poorly controlled, so it's a big number. Asthma is implicated in 255,000 deaths per year in the world. Most asthma-related deaths are preventable. All ages suffer from asthma. It most often starts in childhoods. Gaining control over asthma. Most individuals with asthma accept poorly controlled asthma as normal, although not recognize that their asthma is out of control. Many physicians are not aware when their client's asthma is out of control. Best practice guidelines for nurses are needed to improve understanding and management of asthma. Assessment of asthma control. What we have to assess when we have a patient with asthma. All individuals identified as having asthma or suspecting of having asthma will have their level of asthma control determined by the nurse. Every client should be screened to identify those most likely to be affected by asthma. As part of the basic respiratory assessment, nurses should ask every client 2 questions. Have you ever been told by a physician that you are having asthma? Or have you ever used a puffer, inhaler, or asthma medication for breathing problem? Individuals identified as having asthma or suspected of having asthma, the level of asthma control should be assessed by the nurse. Nurses should be knowledgeable about the acceptable parameters of asthma control, which are use of inhaled short-acting less than 4 times a week, unless for exercise, experience of daytime asthma symptoms less than 4 times a week, experience of nighttime asthma symptoms less than 1 time a week, normal physical activity levels, there is no absence from work or school, and infrequent and mild exacerbations. Indicators of acceptable asthma control. We have the parameter and the frequency. We talked about it in the previous point, so just this, we will just pass by it quickly. If daytime symptoms less than 4 times a week, so it will be acceptable asthma control. Nighttime symptoms lesser than 1 time a week. Needs for short-acting agonist less than 4 times a week. Physical activity, it's unaffected. Exacerbation, it's mild to infrequent. Work or school absence, there is no work or school absence. That's all this point. That means that we have a controlled asthma. Indicator for immediate medical attention. The following criteria should be assessed and supplemented by spirometry, if available. Respiration rate greater than 25 breaths per minute. Pulse greater than 110 beats per minute. Accessory muscle use. Unable to complete a sentence between breaths. Person is distressed, fatigue, exhaustion, and agitated. If person says that they are in trouble or anxious, confusion, and alerted level of consciousness. Asthma education. Asthma education provided by the nurse must be an essential component of care. The client's asthma knowledge and skills should be assessed, and where gaps are identified. Asthma education should be provided. Education should include as a minimum the following: basic facts about asthma, role, rationale of medications, device techniques, self-monitoring, and action plans. What are the action plans for the nurse? Every client with asthma should have an individualized asthma action plan for guided self-management based on evaluation of symptoms with or without peak flow measurement, developed in partnership with a healthcare professional. For every client with asthma, the nurse needs to assess for use or understanding of the asthma action plan. If a client does not have an action plan, the nurse needs to provide a sample action plan to this patient, explain in its purpose and use, and coach the client to complete the plan with his or her asthma care provider. Where deemed appropriate, the nurse should assess, assist, and educate clients in measuring peak expiratory flow rates. A standardized format should be used for teaching clients how to use peak flow measurement. Peak expiration flow. Peak expiration flow, it's a person's maximum speed of expiration as measured with a peak flow meter, a small handheld device used to monitor a person's ability to breathe out air. It measures the airflow through the bronchi and thus the degree of obstruction in the airway. Here are the normal values of the peak expiration flow. Patients. The nurses will understand and be able to discuss with the client their medications. Nurse will understand and be able to discuss the two main categories of asthma medications, controller and reliever, with their clients. All asthma clients should have their inhaler device technique assessed by the nurse to ensure accurate use. Clients with suboptimal technique will be coached in proper inhaler and device use. And the nurse should have the knowledge of medication includes the following: the trade and the generic name, indications, dose, side effects, mode of administration, and pharmacokinetics. Many types of medication for the asthma control medication. First, the long-term asthma control medication, generally taking daily. This medication keeps asthma under control on daily basis and make less likely you will have an asthma attack. Types of long-term control medication include inhaled corticoids, like leukotriene modifier, like long-acting beta agonist, like salmeterol and formoterol, combination inhalers like bronchodilator, like theophylline. We have also the quick relief medications, generally used as needed for rapid, short-term symptoms relief during an asthma attack. Type of quick relief medication is including short-acting beta agonist like the proteasome, like that, and intravenous corticoids like prednisolone and methylprednisolone. What are the education that we should recommend the nurse to be given to the patient? Nurses working individually with asthma must have the appropriate knowledge and skills of the following: assessment of asthma control, effective teaching and communication strategies, assessment for gaps in knowledge and skills, basic components of asthma education, asthma medications, inhaler device technique, purpose for and the general structure of an asthma action plan, use of the peak flow monitoring, and available community resources. Thank you.